Hello, you beautiful individuals. Today we are taking a look at Mr. Matthew Powell. Kent Hovind's illegitimate pseudo son, basically. He's a Kent Hovind Jr. It's all he is. I mean, he apparently looked at Kent Hovind and went, "Man, that's who I want to be." And yeah, now I'm, as far as I can tell, they work together and lie and con people all the same. So, before we start, I did want to take a quick look at something, because I was reading through all this. I don't know if it was on this video or one of the other ones, but I think it was this one. Because I didn't watch this video yet, but I have watched way too many videos of his. And yeah, they're all ridiculous. But anyway, right here. So, he would turn 19, he received basketball scholarships from over 40 different colleges and universities across the USA. Apparently a pretty good basketball player. Apparently so much so that when he attended Calvin College in Grand Rapids, Michigan in 2015, during his time there, some of his friends and... Oh, not that. Where is the part I wanted to read? Oh, right here. So, he has always loved basketball and was looking to become a professional basketball player before becoming a public speaker. And I'm just curious about something. You know, not that I'm doubting that. I don't know. He easily could have been or is a fantastic basketball player. This is not me making fun of him or doubting him. I have no idea. I'm just curious if anyone out there that has either went to school with him in high school or college, was he really that good? Like, was he, you know, as good as he's claiming there? I mean, the only reason I'm even asking is because his, you know, fake dad, Kent Hovind, claims to be a doctor without any doctorate, claims to be a teacher without any teaching degree, and without any actual teaching experience except for lying to children in a church. So, you know, I'm just curious if Matt Powell is as dishonest as Kent Hovind, or if that is just a tidbit about his life that is true, and kind of cool if it is. I've always been a pretty big fan of basketball. You know, I'm not that into sports. I don't keep up with them and all that what stuff, but I do enjoy watching basketball. So, you know, if that is true, kudos. I mean, it's pretty cool. But anyway, now let's get to the making fun of him part, because this, I'm sure, is going to be ridiculous. The Ultimate Defense of Creationism Remastered. So I'm assuming that means this is an older video. I don't know. I didn't see this one, but, you know, I haven't watched every one of his videos. I've tried to watch a fair amount, but they're mind-numbingly ignorant. But yeah, so let's hop into this one. I only moved it ahead a couple seconds here, so it wasn't on a black screen, but we'll start it over.
Hey guys, this is Matt Powell. So evolutionists love to use dinosaurs.
Okay, before we even kick off, well, hold on. Let's figure out what evolutionists love to use dinosaurs for.
To try to disprove the Bible and disprove young earth creationism.
Okay, that's kind of where I assumed that was going. One, evolutionist, really ignorant term. Like, it's they use it on purpose to try to make it seem like a religion, but that's dumb. It's just say scientist. Stop saying evolutionist. Like, the majority of scientists, the majority of people on the planet know that evolution is a thing and understand that it's a concept that's real, and that, you know, I don't know, that bugs me. Second point, I wouldn't say they use it to disprove the Bible. I wouldn't even say they use it to disprove young earth creation, because there's no need to disprove it. I mean, it's already been disproven by the fact that there's so many things on earth that are way older than 6,000 years old. There are stars and galaxies that are farther away from us than 6,000 light years away, which means the light would take longer than 6,000 years to be visible to us, but yet it is. And yes, I know, they could obviously just say, well, God did it, but that's stupid. So, already off to a rough start, Maddie. Let's see what else we got here.
And they will use God's own creation against him. But one of the things that I think is important to share with people and with your children and with your loved ones that believe in evolution is the fact that we actually find soft tissue from dinosaur bones We find collagen, we find blood cells with hemoglobin still in the blood. We also find DNA, dinosaur DNA. And so these are all things that should have deteriorated if they died out 65 plus million years ago.
Okay, for one, I don't know what was up with that widescreen, not widescreen thing. That's a weird choice, but whatever. I guess cinematic or something. But that's not important. So, as I've said multiple times, I'm not a scientist or anything like that. I'm an idiot, quite frankly. I'm not disagreeing with him that they've found, you know, dinosaur DNA and all that kind of stuff. But I'm assuming that it is very, very, very minuscule amounts, like cells of it. I mean, you know, he's making it sound like they found, like, you know, a big old piece of flesh from a dinosaur or something. I guess I get where he's trying to, what he's trying to correlate here. He's saying, since there is this soft tissue that can't last 65 million years, then dinosaurs must only be, what, 6,000 years old, I guess? I don't know. That's dumb for so many reasons. I mean, for one, the amount they have found, I imagine, is very minuscule. And even if it isn't, it surely is only a few examples. I mean, if this was if dinosaurs were really only however many thousand years old, like they have to be to fit into his model of belief, then it should be a really common thing. Like, we should be finding it on a lot of dinosaurs. So that already, I mean, this whole thing is starting off horrible, but let's keep on chugging along.
And so we're finding soft tissue and DNA inside of duck-billed dinosaurs. We're finding it inside of T-Rexes with Mary Schweitzer's discovery in 2005.
Wait. With who? I'm sorry, I struggle to understand him sometimes.
Finding it inside of T-Rexes with Mary Schweitzer's discovery in
Mary Schweitzer. I know that name.
2005 and in 1990. These discoveries literally prove beyond any shadow of doubt that these creatures died recently and not millions of years ago, because organic material can only last a maximum of about 10,000 years before it will deteriorate.
Well, then none of this makes sense for that alone. So you're saying, if what you're saying is true, which I don't know how long organic material lasts, I agree that it's not going to last as long as bones, but that means, so if it lasts up to 10,000 years and the world's only 6,000 years old, then these dinosaurs, we should be finding so much of this. Like, it should be on not every dinosaur fossil or whatever, but it should be on a lot. I mean, what? Hold on, give me 1 second. I gotta look up this Mary, whatever her name is. Okay, so I found her. I definitely get why you struggled with the last name. I'm not 100% sure I'll say it. Mary Schweitzer? Get out of here. I don't know. Get away. Mary Schweitzer, I guess. Sorry if I'm mispronouncing your name. Not that I imagine she would watch this. So I read through this, and there's a couple interesting things I want to point out. Hold on. Give me 1 second. Okay, so right here, her research has been hijacked by young Earth creationists who insist the soft tissue couldn't possibly survive millions of years. Now, I'm going to link this in the description. I'm not going to go over all of this because, you know, it's a fairly lengthy article and I don't want to bore you too much, but essentially what he's saying was correct, that she did find, kind of. Now, he is definitely misleading everyone, because so what she did was took pieces of the bones and then dissolve them in acid, but acid that only dissolves bones and not soft tissue. And by doing that, she found, I mean, when I was right when I say minuscule traces, like, you're talking cells here, like microscopic traces. So I mean, he is being very misleading. And she even says, like in this article, it says that she is a Christian. Like, she is a Christian, believes in God, full of faith and all that good stuff. But still, obviously not a young earth creationist, because she's not an idiot. It angers her that they do this, that young earth creationists try to use her work to essentially confirm their nonsense belief. So, right here, young earth creationists also see her work as revolutionary, but in an entirely different way. And so they apparently first seized her work in the 90s, which makes sense. Probably people like Ken Hovind. There's another, yeah, right here. Okay, they twist your words and they manipulate your data. And that, see, she is religious, okay? She believes in God. She is a Christian, just like you, Mr. Matthew. But the difference is, she's not an idiot. Like, and then it talks about in the end that how she's trying to help, you know, discover and see if there's life on other planets. Makes sense, like Mars and Saturn's moon Titan, because Titan has a crap ton of water on it. But anyway, back to this. I will link that, because I definitely, please go give that a read. Like, it is pretty interesting, and it shows you how misleading he is. What does this shirt say? What evolution? Oh my God! What evolution actually teaches? No, it doesn't. He says this all the time. This is supposed to be reference to the. Someone said that, you know, maybe a monkey, like, they used the wrong word, but they said surfed on a piece of driftwood, and so he takes that way too literally, of course, and is thinking that a monkey is just surfing, having a great old time, and obviously it would be more like clutching on for dear life, trying not to die while floating across the vast ocean, if that's even what happened. I mean, it was just a theory proposed. Like, this is not what evolution teaches. It doesn't have to do with evolution. You're just a moron. But anyway, let's keep going. He's definitely, just like Mr. Hovind, a con man, a liar, a deceiver, misrepresenting actual scientist work, just like this, who I'm assuming is a very nice lady and obviously very smart human being. Like, do you see this? I'm assuming this, yeah, look, red blood cells. You know why they show things like this and like this and that and not just a big old piece of skin or flesh? Because they don't have it. Because it's not around anymore. They were finding microscopic traces of this, of soft tissue or blood or hemoglobin, whatever. Like, ugh.
Now, evolutionists will go running to preservation. They think that preservation techniques are the reason that the dinosaur DNA or blood with hemoglobin in the cells didn't deteriorate for millions and millions of years.
So obviously he didn't read that article, because that's not what it says at all.
And they think that somehow there was preservation that took place. But if I was to take dinosaur soft tissue or DNA and put that DNA inside of an airtight jar, and take that airtight jar and put that in another airtight jar, and then take that airtight jar and put that in another airtight jar, and in another airtight jar and another airtight jar, look, deep time will always cause things to deteriorate.
Okay, but by your own admission, it can survive up to 10,000 years, meaning that we should have so just endless examples of dinosaur soft tissue, because the world supposedly is only 6,000 years old. So I don't get your point here, Matt. And he's done that before, the jar inside a jar inside a jar inside a jar. That's not how, there's different examples of preservation. Like, all right, for example, I don't remember what the president's name was, but I'm sorry. I would look it up, but I just don't care enough right now, and it's not really the point. So they exhumed this president because they wanted to know how he died. And he died, you know, how I think like over 100 years ago. But since he was a president, he had multiple funerals, and they embalmed him so much that when they dug him up, he still pretty much looked the same. Like, you can actually look up his body. Go over to Vlogging Through History's channel. He describes it in a lot better. And but yeah, the point is that there's countless examples of preservation. I mean, it's not man, this is what I mean when I've said he has such a punchable face.
You can't run to preservation and say that somehow it was magically preserved over the course of millions of years. That's just.
Okay, and you can't run to some lady's article and misrepresent it and try to claim that because they found microscopic traces of soft tissue or blood or whatever, saying that means that, oh, all dinosaurs must be young, science is lying, I'm right, I'm the big smart Matt Powell, genius extraordinaire, me and Ken Hovind gonna change the world.
Completely irrational and illogical in every sense of the word.
Everything about you is irrational and illogical in every sense of the word. Literally everything.
And number two, when Mary Schweitzer had to deal with this, because remember, when she made the discoveries in 1990 and in 2005, evolutionists were criticizing her and saying that she needed to come up with a mechanism for how these things lasted for 65 plus million years. So Dr. Schweitzer's conclusion was that if you put dinosaur blood or blood of any creature and encapsulate it in iron, that the iron will preserve the blood cells, and that's how it lasted in deep time. This is their claim. But the tr
That's partially correct, but not entirely, because if you then read that article, which that article's from 2006, if you read that article but then go on to read future articles, you'll find that she not only explains it better, but has that her and multiple others have a much more, well-rounded and more articulated explanation of why it was preserved. And once again, preserved microscopic amounts, like very, very tiny amounts.
Truth is, when we look in nature, we don't see things magically getting encapsulated by iron when they die.
What? What do you? What? When you look in nature, fossils are encapsulated in all sorts of different materials. There are things encapsulated in all sorts of different materials. It's everywhere. You can go out if you have limestone out in your driveway, like for, rocks. You can go out and find some fossils in there. They've been encapsulated in that. Things been getting encapsulated in crap for, guess what, millions upon millions upon millions of years, you muppet.
Nature doesn't do that. I mean, if you slay an animal and you put it out in nature, you even cover it with sediment, nature doesn't automatically just encapsulate dead organisms inside of iron.
No, you're right. They don't. It's definitely going to depend on the situation, where it was covered and where it ended up. But you're missing the part where it takes millions of years. That's why you're not comprehending this, because you think the world's only 6,000 years old, because you're an idiot.
It does the exact opposite. It scatters the DNA molecules. Since when?
Scatters the DNA molecules? Why would it? No, it doesn't. Why would it do that? What are you talking about? Especially depending on the situation. If something gets completely buried in, say, volcanic ash, for example, it's not going to get scattered. It's going to be buried and then preserved. If something gets frozen and encapsulated in ice, it's not going to get scattered. It's going to be flipping frozen until something unfreezes it. Like, what are you talking about?
Does anything in nature die and get encapsulated by iron by nature?
Iron comes from nature, right? Like, iron is a natural thing. You do get that, right? There's iron in your blood, for Christ's sake. What are you talking about? What? This video is even dumber than I thought it was gonna be.
Just doesn't happen.
Like, these are the kind of videos that, like, I know I'm an idiot. Okay, I know I'm not an intelligent person, but gosh dang, listening to him talk makes me feel like a genius because I realize how dumb some people actually are.
So their claim that, well, iron could preserve it, okay, maybe. To claim that nature some...
Wait, what? Okay, maybe? So you just come all of that and you just go, well, okay, maybe. It's possible. What? This is the thing that... Hold on, no, let's make it through this, then I'll rant at the end.
How does this is completely pathetic because we don't ever see that in nature. We don't see organisms getting encapsulated by iron. It just doesn't happen.
Yeah, because we haven't been able to observe things for millions of years. Like, humans... You could argue humans have been around for quite some time, but as far as, like, actually record-keeping humans, you know, more modernish humans, they haven't been around that long, buddy. It's just how it is. I don't...
So their rescue device, that iron could be what's preserving the blood cells, just falls apart at the fundamental of what we observe nature do to organisms that die. Nature doesn't magically encapsulate organisms in iron and magically preserve things. Everything that dies in nature deteriorates over time. And so...
No, it doesn't. Depending on the situation, things do get preserved. Not only what I mentioned just a bit ago, but in a variety of other situations. Things can be preserved in nature. What are you talking about? Is he really this dumb? I mean, your father figure, Kent Hovind, even loves to spew out about trees going through multiple layers, which it's because he doesn't understand things. Those trees are presumably pretty old, and trees are organic material. They're not bone. They deteriorate. They're still there. Like, they've been preserved in a way. I mean, that's not even a good example, but I don't understand how he can say this with a straight face. He's either one of the greatest liars of all time, him and Mr. Hovind. I say Mr. Hovind on purpose, by the way, because he claims to be a doctor, and he's not. So, I don't know. This guy, man, it's so sad to say, but I'd rather cover Kent. Like, Matt is even dumber than him.
Oh, this is just great proof that dinosaur DNA, dinosaur blood that we're finding in all sorts of different dinosaurs, whether it be a T-Rex or...
It's not all sorts of different, like, you are acting like every dinosaur, we're just finding all of this DNA and stuff. And once again, it's microscopic amounts. And more importantly, we're still learning about DNA. I mean, it's, never mind. Just
duckbills, baby duckbills. These things all prove that dinosaurs died recently. Even a child can learn to defend the Bible using God's creation, using his beasts, the dinosaurs. Yeah.
If he was indoctrinated by the Bible, yeah. Like, indoctrinated to believe that, but if he wasn't, guess what? He's not going to, because we don't just believe in the Bible right off the rip. And not only... I don't know. My brain hurts so bad. This guy is so stupid.
And can learn to defeat evolution. This is information that we need to always remember.
And what do you mean defeat evolution? Things evolve. Even in your crazy worldview, if the world's only 6,000 years old, big flood happened 4,000 whatever odd years ago. Okay, so now you have a big boat with all the animals that are left on Earth on this boat. All the other ones are dead. World's been flooded. Okay, cool. How do we have all the animals we have today? Where'd they come from? Did God just start placing them down? No, they would have had to evolve from the animals on the ark. So either way, you believe in evolution. You just believe in a really, really, really fast version of it that makes no sense.
Their weak rescue device of, well, the blood could be preserved by iron. Since when do we see that in nature? Never, because it...
That's one example of seeing it in nature is what she found, but also, once again, you didn't read the article or any follow-up articles, obviously, because you would understand it a lot better if you did.
Doesn't happen.
Well, no, you wouldn't. You're too dumb for that.
Happen, and it doesn't make sense because it's not true. God bless, guys.
Jesus said unto her.
No, I'm not listening to that. Okay. Thankfully, that's over. So, oh my gosh. My entire body hurts from the stupid. Like I said, go read that article, please. And then go read up follow-up articles. Because, don't listen to him. Like, seriously, believe in God. Believe in whatever God and religion you want to. But don't believe the Earth is only 6,000 years old. Because it's not. And it makes no sense. And what else doesn't make sense? So, you have these people, like Mr. Hovind and Mr. Powell here. They are perfectly fine with using computers, obviously, to make their videos and whatnot and post them and share them with the world. Perfectly fine with wearing modern clothing. Perfectly fine, I'm assuming, with driving cars. Perfectly fine with eating the food that most everybody else eats. They're perfectly fine with technology and scientists in almost every aspect of life. But for some reason, evolution, those scientists are wrong. That's wrong. Then they're not even scientists anymore. They're evolutionists. Like, it's so backwards and just I don't know. Anyway, I'm done. That's Matt Powell. Obviously, I'll link this video and I'll link his channel. Please go over there and tell him how ridiculous he is, even though I'm pretty sure he deletes a lot of the comments that don't, you know, that go against him. So those are all liked ones. How about we go, let's look at some comments real quick before we leave. Where did the iron come from? Well, iron is natural. I mean, it's part of nature. It just is. So maybe he doesn't delete things that go against what he believes. Let's just, here's what we're going to do. We're going to write a comment. Here, you can watch it in video. I'm curious to know if he deletes this. So, give me 1 second. Okay, whoops. Let's see if this gets deleted. We'll find out. But anyway, you know, thanks for watching. I just, like I said before, this angers me because it's not the religion part, because I seriously don't care about that. It's the denying science, lying to people, and conning people. That's horrible. I mean, and it's just disgusting. I mean, they claim to be, you know, they believe in God and they follow his word, yet you blatantly lie to people all the time, mislead them, and then try to steal their money. And not only that, like, denying science like this and teaching people to go against science and believe this nonsense way of thinking, it's dangerous. I mean, you're hindering the potential, you know, further advancement of our species. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And until next time.